వాక్యం
గురువాక్యం
మోక్షమూలం
మోక్షమూలం
గురుకృప
గురుకృప.
ఆత్మదర్శనం
ఆత్మదర్శనం
బ్రహ్మదర్శనం
బ్రహ్మదర్శనం
ఆత్మదర్శనం
ఆత్మదర్శనం
బ్రహ్మదర్శనం
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 సత్యదర్శనం
సత్యదర్శనం
బ్రహ్మదర్శనం
బ్రహ్మదర్శనం
సత్యదర్శనం
సత్యదర్శనం.
హరి ఓం
హరి ఓం
గురుభ్యో నమః
శ్రీ గురుభ్యో నమః.
హరిహి ఓం
హరిహి ఓం.
మై ప్రణామ్స్ టు ఆల్ ఆత్మజ్యోతిస్ డివైన్ లైట్ ఆఫ్ ది సెల్ఫ్. విల్ కంటిన్యూ విత్ ద కఠోపనిషత్, ది డయలాగ్ బిట్వీన్ ద లార్డ్ ఆఫ్ డెత్ యమధర్మరాయ అండ్ ది యంగ్ బాయ్ నచికేత, హూ ఈస్ రిప్రజెంటేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎన్ ఐడియల్ స్పిరిచువల్ సీకర్. స్పిరిచువల్ సీకర్ షుడ్ అప్రోచ్ ద ట్రూత్ ఈస్ రిప్రజెంటెడ్ త్రూ నచికేత. నచికేత ఈస్ నాట్ ఈవెన్ అఫ్రైడ్ ఆఫ్ డెత్ ఇన్ సర్చ్ ఫర్ ది ట్రూత్. Nachiketa is not interested in any of the wealth, money, women, power. He is only looking for truth from the spiritual master Yamadharmaraya, who is a realized soul, who represents an ideal teacher. So there is a dialogue between an ideal teacher and an ideal student. This reminds us of Bhagavad Gita, where there is also a dialogue where Krishna is master, spiritual master, and Arjuna is a seeker. There the spiritual master Krishna is avatar purusha, very highly enlightened being, whereas Arjuna approaches Krishna out of the difficulties and confusions he has in life, seeing the warfare. So there is a dialogue between the master and a disciple. Master is enlightened, a disciple is confused in case of Bhagavad Gita. In case of Kathopanishad, master is enlightened, disciple is also, disciple is not confused, disciple is very clear what he is looking for. He is looking for enlightenment. He is not confused like Arjuna. He is very, very clear, say, this is what I want, and he is not ready to accept anything less than that. So this is the dialogue between a very highly enlightened master and a disciple, a great disciple. So we'll see what happens further.
ప్రతిభాతి
మూఢం అయం లోకో नास्ति पर इति मानि
मानि
पुनः
पुनः
पुनर्वशत
पुनर्वशत
आपपद्यते
आपपद्यते.
So Yamadharmaraya says there are kids, okay, there are kids who are on the wrong path. They are deluded by the money and they think there is neither future, okay, there is no future, nothing called future, nothing called world beyond. Other than what I see, there is nothing. And such a person comes back to me again and again. Yamadharmaraya is the lord of death. So a person who is deluded will come back to Yamadharmaraya again and again. Now he calls these as kids. Okay? There are a lot of kids around who have a lot of money or who are enamored by money, who are attracted by money or who have a lot of money. Okay. Some things like money, power, the beauty gets into the head of the people. Okay. When you have power, you start behaving as if you are the lord, you are the god, and everybody else who has no power as slaves. The person with money thinks that anything I can buy with money, everything is possible. Nothing seems to be impossible for a person with money. Right? Then there's beauty. When somebody is beautiful, people look at that person. Okay? Everybody is looking at me. I'm so beautiful. Right? This gets into the head. And person of that nature, who is deluded by what he has, no video is coming, seems.
Others are
getting. Is it? There are people who are these deluded people, Yamadharmaya calls them as kids. And especially the people who have a lot of money and money has got into their head. When the person has a lot of money, he starts thinking, okay, he can buy anything, whether it's a vehicle or servants or the goods, anything he wants, he can buy. So now when he does that, when he thinks that all the power on the world is in his hands, and he thinks that this is life and there's nothing more than this in life. See, is there something beyond what we are living at this moment? That question doesn't come to somebody who is very happy, who is very comfortable with his life. Only when you become uncomfortable, you start thinking, is there something beyond? Is there a way out of this situation? A person who is very comfortable, he doesn't think anything else. Let me enjoy this moment. There's nothing more than this moment. That's what he starts thinking. And these people earlier days were called charvakas. Charvaka means charuvaka. Charu means sweet talk. Vak means charuvaka means the one who talks sweet. The main principle of their life was ranam kratva gratam pibeta. Ranam kratva gratam pibeta. Their advice to their children, their relatives, their friends is enjoy life today. If you don't have money, borrow money and buy ghee and enjoy life. Oh, what happens that fellow comes and catches you tomorrow? Tomorrow we'll see. Now suppose I die. There's nothing after death. What is there is at this moment. So this is the concept these people called Charvakas had. And nowadays, modern people also have the same concept. They have only reality is the body. Of the body goes, nothing is there. They don't understand that there's something called consciousness, which is actually beyond body. The consciousness is the what uses the body. You are not the body. Your life is not ending today. Life will continue forever. And Yamadharmaraya says, such people keep on coming to me again and again. After death, they are not liberated. Because of their ignorance, they keep on coming. You may believe that only this body is life. After death, nothing is there. But that is not the reality in the universe. After death, the person's soul will go back to Yamadharmaraya and again take birth. This process will continue until a point of time, after maybe thousands of lifetimes or millions of lifetimes, the person realizes there is something beyond the body. There is a consciousness which is one with Paramatma, one with the Supreme Reality. If this, until this realization comes, the person will keep on getting trapped. The person gets trapped in the cycle of birth and death. And Yamadharmaraya says they are kids. They are not grown up. A grown up person understands. Grown up person acquires maturity in life. He understands. Money is not all. Today they have money, tomorrow the money disappears. A person who is beautiful today, called beauty queen, tomorrow she will be called auntie. Day after tomorrow she is called nani. Right? So the beauty disappears. The power, whether it's elected power or selected power, the person in the proportion of power will have to give up the power. After your retirement, before your retirement, whenever you go to the office, there is so much of respect for you. After your retirement, if you go to the office, you have to take a permission to go inside. Nobody cares for you. The power disappears, the beauty disappears, the money disappears. Is there something valuable in life? Is there something worthwhile in life? And that worthwhile is there. That is your consciousness. That is not recognized by people who are deluded by money. That's why Yamadharmaraya says these are kids. That doesn't mean that don't acquire money. Okay, that doesn't mean that run away from life. Do what you have to do in life. But don't get trapped by them. Trapped by that. What is required for your life? Do it. You need some money, earn it. But let that not take over your mind. Let that not take over your soul. Shravanayapi.
Shravanayapi.
Bahubhiryo.
Bahubhiryo.
Na labhyah.
Na labhyah.
Shrunvantopi.
Shrunvantopi.
Bahavo.
Bahavo.
Yamna vidyuhu.
Yamna vidyuhu.
Ascharyo.
Ascharyo.
Vakta.
Vakta.
Kushalo.
Kushalo.
Asya labdhan.
Asya labdhan.
Ascharyo.
Ascharyo.
Nata.
Nata.
Kushala anushishtaha.
Kushala anushishtaha.
This something which is beyond your life, beyond your body and mind is there. Something which is beyond your body and mind is more valuable than anything which you have. Money, power, relatives, friends, okay, beauty. Beyond that, there's something much more valuable than that is in your life. But unfortunately, people cannot get to hear that. There's no opportunity for people to know about it. You know something when you hear about it. There's no opportunity to hear about that something much valuable in you. Many people don't even have the opportunity to hear about you, hear about that. There are very few people who get the opportunity to hear about it. But even after hearing it, they may not get the opportunity to realize it. There are some people who can, there are only very few people who can talk about this reality. That's a wonder. There are only very few people who are fortunate, who are skillful, or who are smart in the language of the world of this language. Okay? They will understand this truth from the one who knows it. This wonder of wonders. So now we are here today in the modern day, we call a person as smart man, smart boy, smart guy, smart lady, right? Somebody who is able to talk very quickly, think on their feet and give smart answers are called smart people, right? Whatever the answers they give, they should be able to give answers which will confuse you or do whatever is that. But they should be able to get away from the situation. Such a person is called smart. But earlier days, the definition of smart, they also use the word called kushala. Kushala means smart. Only a smart people, they define smart people as one who is ready for listening the truth from a realized master and realizes the truth is called smart. Other people are called dumb people in the earlier days. So the times have changed. Somebody who listens about the spirituality or truth becomes a dumb person, and somebody who is is able to talk whatever he wants to talk in a nice way and get away with that is called a smart person. The times have changed. So here it says, there are very, very few people on the world who get an opportunity to hear about the truth, about that supreme reality. Your communication, what do you hear in your life, please tell me? Newspaper. Take a newspaper, read from beginning to end. There will be not a single line about the self, Atma, Brahman, the higher consciousness. You can find murder, rape, crimes, politicians, petrol price rise, everything you can find, but you cannot find something about truth. Even if it's found, it will be given a small column somewhere. Okay, rest of things are big document. You switch on the TV, keep on, and of course there are some channels nowadays, spiritual channels, otherwise you keep on hearing, okay, about things, but not about the self of supreme reality. And you talk to your friends. What do you talk to your friends? Have you talked to your friends anything meaningful in life? Keep on talking about your profession, this happened, that happened, the vegetable prices, cricket match, anything you talk. Right? Nothing worthwhile, nothing which will uplift you, elevate you. And talk to your wife or husband. If at all you talk after a couple of years of marriage, okay, right? It's supposed to be that initially the husband talks, after the wife talks, after the child talks and husband and wife listen, right? So like that, if at all you talk, what do you talk? Do you talk something about worthwhile, which uplifts you, which elevates you? That truth is available to very few people. No, I am religious. I belong to this religion or that religion. Religion for most of the people has become certain set of rituals. Even if you go to holy places, even if you celebrate festivals, the original meaning, original truth which is there about self-realization is not told, not disclosed. And probably many people are not interested, that's what this case is. Very few people are interested also. Okay. And those who listen to the truth, many of them, even after they listen to the truth, they will not realize, they will not understand. Because it's very subtle. The truth is very subtle. The truth is very simple. Satyam Shivam Sundaram, its truth is beautiful. It is very simple. The truth is truth. truth cannot be complex. Truth is always very simple. And mind always looks for complexity. Okay? Mind doesn't accept anything which is simple. You go to a shop. You want to buy two gift items. 500 rupees, 1000 rupees. Same gift item. Sir, what is this? These two gift items? Sir, this is made in China, this is made in America. Both are same, both are labels are different. This is 1000 rupees. So you buy 1000 rupees wala because thinking that 1000 rupees is gives you more quality. The mind is constantly looking for complexity. Mind creates very complex situations. The truth being so simple, straightforward, mind misses it. That is the beauty of the truth. The truth is in front of you, truth is behind you, truth is within you, truth is above you, truth is below you. That is missed by the mind because mind looks for complexity, not simplicity. So even if many people listen to the truth, they'll miss it. There are very, very few people, very noble souls who have realized the truth. It is very difficult to find such a noble soul who has realized the truth. Very, very difficult. Because such noble souls are rare. And they don't show off. And those who show off may not be noble. Simplicity, humility, silence and peace are hallmark of a realized soul. Simplicity, silence, love, compassion are the marks of a realized soul. Please tell me with what meter you measure the simplicity. How do you measure the simplicity of a person? Please tell me, how do you measure the peaceful nature of a person? Please let me know, how do you know the compassion of a person? How do you know the silence? Our mind is tuned for noise. The more noise somebody makes, the more you get attracted. The one in the modern day, one who makes more noise becomes more popular. A realized soul is not looking for popularity. So how do you find him? It's very difficult. He will be so simple, it will be difficult for you to distinguish him from other people. His compassion many times is mistaken for his weakness. It is very difficult to find who is a realized soul for most of the people because our minds are tuned for complex things. So most of the people get attracted to a Mahatma or a so-called Mahatma because of their outer look, not the inner qualities. To recognize that inner qualities, at least you should need some quality, no? You need some quality, right? You go to a music class, your music performance, Carnatic music, that person starts singing sa sa pa pa. After some time you will start getting headache. This guy, what is this? Right? He is actually telling a raga, most beautiful raga, but you cannot appreciate because you will start getting headache, right? All that in your life you know only some ding 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 jing bang musics, film musics, and real classical music will give you a headache to you. So to know a classical music, to know, appreciate classical music, at least you should have knowledge of music. To know a realized soul, at least you should have some noble quality, otherwise you can't recognize a noble soul. that's why it said, when you are ready, the master will come into your life. When you are ready means, when you have developed certain qualities to recognize the master, you will recognize the master. Otherwise, master will be there always with you. But you are not able to recognize that master because your mind is tuned for complexity, not simplicity. It's a wonder that there are some realized souls are there who can speak about this truth. He says it's a wonder. Okay? And it's a wonder that there are some smart students also. Those are called smart students here. Kushala means smart. Who are able to recognize such a master, go to that master and listen to the truth and realize. So this is what Yamadharma Raya is telling.
Narena.
आवरणेन
प्रोक्तयेषा
सुविज्ञेयो
बहुधा
चिन्त्यमाना
अनन्यप्रोक्ते
गतिरत्र नास्ति
अणीयान्
ह्यतर्क्यम्
अनुप्रमाणात्
Then he tells about the pitfalls in the spiritual life. Somebody who is not enlightened, somebody who is a lower quality teacher, who is not a realized soul, but he is able to teach, lower quality teacher. He calls Hina. Hina means lower level. From such a person, you cannot realize the self. By listening to such a person, you will not be able to realize the truth. For realizing the truth, you should go to a realized master. That's because many people think of the self in many ways. Self is thought in many ways, depending on their impressions of life, vasana. They think of self in different ways. So for most of the people who are watching television nowadays, so the self is Atma. Atma comes and goes because the past life regression, Atma has come from this body and it's gone into some body. Okay? For some people, the self means the body. Body is the self. For some people, mind is the self. For some people, intellect is the self. What is self for all of you? For each of you to question, what is the self for you? You think body is yourself? Or you think mind is yourself? Or you think intellect is yourself? A person who thinks body is himself or herself, his words will be like this: I look handsome, I am beautiful. So because I am becomes beauty, body, which is related to body. Somebody who is identified in the mind, starting, I am happy person, happiness is related to mind. I am a sad person, it's not related to body, it's related to mind. A person who is intellect, I am a smart person, I am intellectual, you say. So, identification can be the body, mind or intellect. Now, if you go to such persons, whenever they teach spiritual truths, what they will say? They will confuse more. Okay? All teachings will be corrupted by their thinking of the self. What they think as the self will be coming as a part of the teaching. So then what will you learn from them? How can you learn from them? Only a realized master who has gone beyond body, mind and intellect will be able to tell the truth in a very, very clear fashion. And when the truth is told in a very clear fashion or clear way, you can appreciate the truth. So what is the truth? Nanu.
Nanu.
Nanembudu.
Nanembudu.
Nanalla.
Nanalla.
Nanu.
Nanu.
Nanembudu.
Nanembudu.
Nanalla.
Nanalla.
Ideha.
Ideha.
Manabuddhi.
Manabuddhi.
Nanalla.
Nanalla.
Sachidanandatma.
Sachidanandatma.
Shivananunani.
Shivananunani.
Shivoham.
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 The truth is, you are not a body. You are not a mind. You are not an intellect. You are the consciousness which animates this body, mind and intellect. You are the truth. That is the truth. So this cannot be communicated clearly by an unrealized person, because his concept of the truth will be little body and mind. He cannot think anything beyond the body and mind. If you have not seen something, if you have not experienced something, you will not be able to talk about it confidently. Have you heard of a frog in the well? There was a frog in the well. It was living happily there. One day a bird comes there and starts singing. The bird starts singing about the ocean, where there's lots and lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of water. The frog gets curious. You're saying lot of water? Yes. How much water? Lots. So the frog shows its hand. Is more than this much water? The frog, you can imagine the small hands of the frog. With that hand, frog is showing. More than this much water? Yes, of course. Then frog is wondering, how much water should be? Is there more than the water in this well? Ayyo, much more than that. That frog says, you are a liar. You are a cheat. There's no such thing possible. The water in this itself is so much, there's nothing more than this is possible. So many of the people, many of the teachers, or many of the people who speak about Atma are like frogs in the well. They have not seen beyond that well. So what they can teach about the ocean, your consciousness is like an ocean. One who has not seen the ocean can talk about ocean comfortably. And if he can only talk about well, and as long as you keep on listening about well, you will be in the well. But you may not be well. To become well, you don't need to know about ocean. Right? This is the teaching of the shloka. There is no, you will not be able to realize the truth from an unrealized person. This is the meaning of the shloka. So why that is so? Because the self is subtler than the subtlest. It cannot be grasped by the intellect. Mind and intellect and senses cannot understand the truth. So then how do you understand the truth? When the mind, intellect and senses cannot understand the truth, the only way to understand the truth is to be the truth. To know the truth is not possible, because to know you need a mind. When you become the truth, you realize the truth. So one who has realized the truth becomes the truth. That's why he is called Brahmavid Brahmaiva Bhavati. Knower of Brahman becomes Brahman himself. That's the meaning. If you know, you cannot know God. Please understand, you cannot know God. You can know about God. Okay? But you can be God when you drop your ego. Any knowing is through ego. Okay? God is not a subject to be known. There are many people think that they know so much about God. Don't you? You know where is the address of God? Where he stays? What all things he is doing at a moment of time? All that you have to switch on is 7:30 p.m. the television channel. You know exactly where God is. What he is doing at this moment. The TV serials are there. Many TV serials, right? So God is not an object to be known. God is the subject. Okay? God is your own self. Only when you drop your ego self, then you realize the supreme in you. This is the meaning of the story. We'll close for the day. We'll do a few minutes of meditation. Close your eyes, sit comfortably. Tighten your left leg, tight, relax. Tighten your right leg, tight, relax. Tighten your left hand, tight, relax. Tighten your right hand, tight, relax. Tighten your stomach, tight, relax. Tighten your chest, tight, relax. Tighten your face, tight, relax. Tighten your back, tight, relax. Your whole body is relaxed. Keep your left hand on the stomach. Become aware of the breathing. Your hand moves with the breath. As you become aware of breath, the breath starts slowing down. When the breath starts slowing down, the mind also starts slowing down. When the mind and breath are slowed down, you feel very relaxed. You are not the body, mind or intellect. You are the witness, sakshi for the body, mind and intellect. You are aware of what's happening in the mind, but you are not the mind, you are awareness. Asatoma.
Asatoma.
Sadgamaya.
Sadgamaya.
Tamasoma.
Tamasoma.
Jyotirgamaya.
Jyotirgamaya.
Mrityorma.
Mrityorma.
Amritam gamaya.
Amritam gamaya.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Let all living beings,
land, sea,
forest,
and
sky,
have peace.
ಸಾಹುಕಾರ ವಿಠೋಬ ನಿರೋದು ನದಿ ತೀರ Amba, Shanti.